sexuality. Some prakim or psukim in different kapitel of Tehillim or even in different books of the Tanakh that reflect and expand on what we say in Hallel. And we're going to do that this week. Last week we did prakim 113, 114, and 115. This week we're going to look at 116, 117, and 118, which is the end of the Hallel. Even more than the prakim and the chapters we talked about last week, these chapters create this tapestry. And the hardest thing about preparing this was trying to figure out how to separate out the threads and weave them back together for you in a way that would make sense. So I'm going to give it a try because it really is all woven together in this most incredible way. So the first thing I want to point out about chapter 116 is it goes from the rabbin, from the plural, into the singular, into the yachid. Whereas before it was about us, lo lanu Hashem, lo lanu, v'anachnu nevarechka, and we will bless God. Now it's about me, ahavti ki yishma Hashem et koli tachnunai. I love that Hashem listens to my voice, to my pleading. So we've gone from the communal to the very personal. We'll get back to the communal. But it's going to be phrased about me, my relationship with HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So the first thing I want to show you is a series of repetitions or echoes of what we're reading. Pasuk Bet. Verse 2, Uviyamai Ekra, I call upon him all my days. Verse 4, Uvashem Hashem Ekra, I will call the name of Hashem. Verse 13, Uvashem Hashem Ekra, I will call upon the name of Hashem. Verse 17, Uvashem Hashem Ekra, I will call upon the name of Hashem. There is this sort of chorus, that's what this Hallel is all about, me calling on the name of Hashem. And I'll give you a piece of advice. If you think you're going to say it by heart, you can't, because you're going to get to the wrong Uvashem Hashem Ekra, and then you're going to realize you forgot some psukim. So you always have to look inside while you're reading the Hallel. Next, Pasuk Aleph, Tachanunai, which is reflected in verse 5, Pasuk A, Chanun Hashem Batsadik. Tachanunai, or I'm asking Hashem to be gracious to me. It's translated supplications, but that's what Tachanunim are. And then in verse 5, I recognize that Chanun Hashem, God is gracious and will be gracious to me. Next, verse 3, Chevle Mavet, the cords of death. And go down to verse 8, Ki chilatzta nafshi mimavet. He has delivered my soul from death. So first I have the cords of death surrounding me in Pasuk Gimel, and by Pasuk Chet, God has saved me. Next, verse 4, Malta nafshi. Now, aside from me, I'm going to start talking about my nefesh, my soul, my spirit. Maltal nafshi, deliver my soul, go down to verse 7. Shuvi nafshi, return my soul, go down to verse 8. Ki chilatzta nafshi mimavet, you have delivered my soul. So it's me, it's graciousness, it's my soul that keeps being repeated over and over again. But wait, there's more, as they used to say in infomercials, right? Ana Hashem, Malta Nafshi, in verse 4, please Hashem, or I beseech you, which is the translation here, and it appears again in verse 16. Ana Hashem, ki ani avdecha. Please Hashem, And of course, as we all know, in chapter 118, Ana Hashem Hoshiana, Ana Hashem Hatzlichana. So the Ana Hashem, please Hashem, keeps repeating itself too as a theme. Next. Verse 7. Ki Hashem Gomal Aloichi. Because Hashem has dealt bountifully with my soul. And then verse 12, Kol Tagmuloi Olai. Gamal Tagmuloi, it's the same thing. As in Gmilut Chasadim, doing something for someone. So that Gamal, that being repeated, that being kind, doing something for someone, is repeated. And finally, if you look at verse 14, my vows I will pay to Hashem in front of his entire nation. And once again, in verse 18, exactly the same word for word. Another reason to look inside while you're davening. And so, you have these repeating themes of God being good, of God being gracious, of God doing for me, of my soul being involved, of God saving me from death. These are the repeating themes for which I am thankful in Hallel, and that's what I mean by the tapestry being woven back and forth. In addition, there's a concept called tzlil chozer, a sound that repeats. Just as I say, these are sort of a chorus or a mantra that we get into, a repeating sound will do the same thing. So let's just take a look for an example in verse 3, Pasukim. Afafuni chevle mavet umitzare sha'ol mitza'uni tzara v'yagon emtza. It is not coincidental that sadi, what some people call tzadik, repeats itself over and over again in that pasuk. Tzadi is not the letter that you usually see that occurs so frequently in Jewish texts. And yet, four times in one pasuk, I have this sound, which is sort of getting me into this cadence of what the Hallel is trying to do. All right. So, let's go and take a look at some psukim that I chose from different prakim, different chapters in Tehillim. For chapter 116, I limited myself to the book of Psalms because this could be 25 pages long if I went to every single book of the Tanakh, but I figured this gives us a taste. Now, the intertextuality is important. Intertextuality means themes, words, sounds that appear in different places in the Tanakh, not only because of what we talked about last week, which means that every author of every Sefer in the Tanakh knew about the other Sfarim. They are all joined in the Masorah that begins at Sinai and the tradition that originated in Sinai. But it enriches our understanding because as we look at some of the rest of these psukim, it's going to answer explicit or implicit questions of how and why. So let's take a look at verse 1. Ahavti ki yishma Hashem et koli tachnunai. I love that Hashem listens to my voice and my pleas. You go into chapter 28, Baruch Hashem ki shama kol tachnunai. So, God did do it in the past, and I love that God will continue to do it in the future. Next, Pasuk Bet. Ki hitoaz no li uv'yamai ekra. He has turned his ear to me, therefore I will call upon him during my days. And in chapter 17, Ani karaticha ki ta'aneni ker. I call to you because I am suffering. Hataz nechali shma imrati. Turn your ear to me. listen to what I'm saying to you. And now in Hallel, I say, you've done it. Thank you, Hashem. I am praising you because this is what you have done for me. Next. Afafuni chedle mavet mitzurei sha'ol mitzuni tzaravi agon etza. The cords of death have surrounded me. The straits of the world below have gotten hold of me, and I found trouble and suffering. And in chapter 18, it tells me how and why. Afafuni chedle mavet, exactly the same phrase, the cords of death encompass me. V'nachale bilia'al yivatuni. And the nachal is a stream that all of a sudden picks up and flows wildly. Bilial, of those who have rejected the yoke of God, terrified me. All of a sudden, these people who reject God are like a nachal, this flowing stream, and they terrified me. Chedle sh'ol sivavuni, the cords of the grave surrounded me. Kidmuni mokshe mavet. They were before me like entrapment of death. That's the expansion of what does this mean, the cords of death have encompassed me. It's people who are trying to make me leave you, Hashem, and I will not do it. That's the enrichment of our pasuk when we see other psukim. And it goes further. Tsar umatsok mitzauni mitzvotecha sha'ashuai. When suffering finds me, your mitzvot are my delight. That's the but at the end of the sentence, right? The cords of death encompass me, but your mitzvot delight me. So I don't worry about it if I have an opportunity to do your mitzvot. Shem Hashem Ekra, Ana Hashem Malta Nafshi, I beg of you, Hashem, deliver my soul. Now, Malta and Palta, which you'll see on the left side, are actually similar words. What are you delivering my soul from? Palta Nafshi Me Rasha. Hashem is delivering my soul from the evil, Charbecha, with your sword. So the sub rosa text here is, what is Hashem delivering me from? From my enemy. From the person who wants to do evil to me, essentially because they hate Hashem. Okay. Hanun Hashem v'tzadik v'lokeinu merachem. We're in verse 5. Gracious is Hashem and righteous, and our God is compassionate, which we see in the perek immediately before Hallel starts. Hallel begins in chapter 113. In chapter 112, we say, Hashem is chanun v'rachum v'tzadik. So this chapter is hearkening back right before Hallel. It's sort of a penumbra, an aura around the chapters of Hallel, saying they don't really begin at 113. We're really leading up to them. They climax between 113 and 118, and then, of course, we go into chapter 119, if you're familiar with the Tehillim. 117 is the shortest chapter in the entire Tanakh, to Psukim. 119 is the longest chapter in the Tanakh, 176. So, somebody was messing with us. Verse 6 is one of my favorite Psukim. Shomer Ta'im Hashem Taloti Duliyo Hashia. Hashem preserves the simple. I was brought low and he saves me. Now, let me explain to you why. Are you familiar with the tradition that every one of us has a pasuk that starts with the first letter of our name and ends with the last letter of our name? My name is Sheva. Shomer Ta'im Hashem Taloti Duliyo Hashia. And this so applies to me, right? God preserves the simple. I was brought low. God brought me up, and I take this pasuk very, very seriously because it's my pasuk. My parents had a moment of nevuah, I guess, when they named me Sheva. Shuvi nafshi limnuchaychi ki Hashem gomal aloichi. Now, this limnuchaychi and aloichi is not mine, is yours. It is an old Tanakhi construct of limnu chayich. It's talking about the nefesh. The nefesh is nekeva. So limnu chayichi is to your rest, my nefesh. Ki Hashem gamal alayich is ki Hashem gamal alayich. God has done good for you. Now, anybody who thinks modern Hebrew and Tanakhi Hebrew are the same language, try getting off the plane in Israel and saying limnu chayichi. They're going to look at you like you have six heads. But what a beautiful way to say it, because the e mine is encompassed into the your, but limnu chayichi means your rest. Alayichi means upon you. And then, of course, we have the parallels of nafshi. Ma tishtochachi nafshi, tehemi alai, hochili le'elokim, ki'oda den yushua panav. This is when my soul is downcast. And even though my soul is downcast, once I'm saying Hallel, return my soul to your rest. You're okay. I'm saying Hallel. Hashem is taking care of you. Let's go on. Ki chilatzta nafshi mimavet, you have delivered my soul from death, et einim in dema, my eyes from tears, et ragli midechi, my feet from stumbling. Why? The intertext will tell us why, and this comes from chapter 56. Ki chilatzta nafshi mimavet, halo ragli midechi, exactly the same phrase. Because you have saved my soul from death, and have not saved my feet from stumbling, lehitalech lifnei Elokim ba'or hachayim. Why are you doing this? Why did you do this? So that they can walk before Hashem in the light of living. So the intertext gives us the why. Why has Hashem saved me? Over and over again in the Hallel, we're going to come across the theme of the dead can't bless you. Keep me alive. I want to bless you. And indeed, that is so much of what the Hallel is, which may be another reason that Deb's gonna smile at this. Hallel may or may not be said in Shiva houses because it is so focused on the living as contrasted with the dead who can no longer praise Hashem. All right. Let's go to verse 11. Va'ani amarti b'chavzi kol adam kozev. So I took this translation, but the more I looked at it, the more I don't like it. Chavzi, I think, is more alarm than haste. Chifazon is, you know, in a hurry, but it's like an alarmed hurry, right? So B'nai Yisrael left Mitzrayim b'chifazon, in a hurry. But it's not just that they were rushing. It's that there was this alarm that made them be fast. So, ani amarti b'chavzi, I said in my hurried alarm, kol adam kozev, all men are corrupt. Supposedly, David HaMelech wrote this pasuk in reaction to one of the times Shaul was chasing him and trying to kill him. It's understandable if he's doing that, but for us, it's much more generalized than that. Va'ani amarti b'chavzi, says chapter 31, negrasti mineged einecha, achein shamata kol tachnunai b'shavi elecha. I said, in alarm, I was thrust out from before your eyes, therefore you listen to the voice of my pleas when I turn to you. And zuchor ani mechol, remember for me how short life is. Alma shav barata kol b'nei adam. So why have you created human beings in vain? Again, we get to this theme of life versus death, the life praising God, the dead no longer able to praise God. Nidarai l'Hashem ha'shalem, verse 14, negdan al'chol amo. Me'itcha tihilati b'kol rav, from you is my praise and a great congregation. Nidaraya shalem. There's our parallel phrase. My vows I will pay, but before whom? Neged yireyav. before those who fear him. So it gets more specific than ours. Before his people, what does his people mean? His people mean those who fear him, being a Kadosh Baruch Hu. And again, we see that Yomruna Beit Aharon, the house of essentially the Kohanim, will say, Hili Olam Chasto, Yomruna Yirei Hashem, those who fear God. The Kohanim, Israel, and those who fear God are God's people. And they say, Hili Olam Chasto, his kindness is forever. Verse 16. Ana Hashem ki ani avdecha, ani avdecha ben amakecha. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid, pitachta lomosei rai, you have opened my bands, that which kept me tied up. And in chapter 86, Pnei Eli v'chaneni, Tana uzcha la'avadecha v'hoshia l'ven amotecha. This harkens back to what we talked about last week with Akeret HaBayit, and how women are sort of behind the scenes, and yet they always appear. A person cannot exist unless he is ben amotecha, the son of essentially the one who gave birth to him, his mother, the maidservant of God. Eved and Ama, two parallel things. I am your servant, but I am your servant because my mother gave birth to me, my mother raised me, my mother was your maidservant. Now, the next two psukim are gonna get really interesting. L'chol ezbach zabach todah uv'shem Hashem ekra. I will give you the zabach todah, which is the karban, the sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call in Hashem's name. Nidarai l'Hashem ha'shalei nekdan olachol amo. I will pay my vows to Hashem, opposite, in front of his entire nation. But look at the other two psukim on the left side. Zebach lelokim toda, v'shalem le'elyon nidarecha, olay elokim nidarecha ashalem todat lach. So when you go into the pasuk in chapter 50 and the pasuk in chapter 56, it's chiastic. First comes the toda, and then comes the neder in 50, but in 56, first comes the neder, and then comes the toda. What comes first? My promising to give thanksgiving to God, or my feeling thanksgiving to God, and therefore I promise to bring something to him? The answer is yes. Because in our tehillim, it's in two different psukim, which means it perpetuates. It's not that one comes before the other. It is that I feel thanksgiving and I bring my neder. And because I bring my neder, I realize how much God has given to me. And because I realize how much God has given to me, I get involved in thanksgiving to God and I bring a neder. That's why it's two psukim. It's the indication that it's a perpetual cycle. And in truth, is that not what gratitude should be? Gratitude shouldn't be, oh, last Thursday was Thanksgiving, so today I'm grateful for this and this and this. Gratitude is self-perpetuating. The more grateful I am, the more I notice what I have around me. The more I notice what I have around me, the more grateful I am. So even though we don't give karbanot anymore, we no longer have sacrifices, the gratitude and the philosophy behind Zevach Todah should stay. As we express our gratitude and Neshama Parim Sipateinu, Tefillah has replaced the Karbanot, I should feel even more grateful for what I have. And once again, I should want to praise Hashem. And then, another Karban is added, which is Avo Beitecha V'Olot. The Olot is the burnt offering, Ashalei Lecha Nidarai. The Olah is different because the entire thing is burnt. Whereas I get something out of a Karban Todah, I get nothing out of an Olah because the entire thing is an offering to Hashem. how much more grateful I am when I give it all away, so to speak. Then, Pasuk Yutet, V'chatzrot Beit Hashem B'tochech Yerushalayim Halalucha is parallel to a Pasuk in chapter 135, which is the chapter leading into what is called Hallel HaGadol, which we talked about, and some people actually consider chapter 135 part of Hallel HaGadol. Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Shem Hashem, Hallelujah, Dei Hashem, Sh'omdim Beit Hashem, B'chatzro. Parallel to ours, Beit Elokeinu. But look at the difference between 135. B'chatzrot Beit Elokeinu. Elokeinu is our one sub-aspect of HaKadosh Baruch Hu Kiviyachol, because God cannot be broken down. But our verse says B'chatzrot Beit Hashem Yud Kei Vav Kei. When I'm saying Hallel, I stand in the courtyard of the entirety, of the essence, of the Shem HaMeforash, of everything that God is. That's the courtyard that I am honored and privileged to stand in when I stand before HaKadosh Baruch Hu singing Hallel. So that's chapter 116. Any questions or comments before we go on to 117? Because if you think it was arcane today, just wait. 117, this very short little parak, is going to be the bridge between 116 and 118. And as an introduction to 118, it has the three types of praise we do for Hashem. Hallelu, Shabchuhu, and Hodu. So in these three psukim, we have Hallelu et Hashem kol goyim, Shabchu kol hokmim, ki gavar aleinu chasto. And then we're going to go into Hodu Hashem ki tov ki li'olam chasto. Now, at the end of 115, not at the end, in 115, if you remember, there is a pasuk, Lama yamru hagayim ane yena elokehem. The nations say, where is your God? But now we've turned that around. Because when we keep saying Hallel, what is going to happen? Hallelu et Hashem kol gayim. Everyone is going to see the power of God. They will no longer need to ask, Gayena Elokechem. They will know where our God is. Because they too will be praising Hashem. Shabchu kol amim. All the peoples of the world will be extolling God. And that's really what we're going for. So we go from B'chatzrot Beit Hashem B'tochech Yerushalayim, very specific to the Jewish people, to this broader Kol Goyim, Kol Ha'umim, and then we're going to zoom in and zoom out again. We're going to zoom into Yomarna Yisrael, zoom in even further to Yomruna Beit Aharon, and zoom out to Yomru Yirei Hashem. Yirei Hashem will include Kol Goyim, Kol Ha'umim, right? V'haya v'yom ha'hu, Yeh Hashem Echad, Ushma Echad. That's what we're saying here, where everyone will recognize this as Hashem. The other interesting thing about this is that Shem Hashem Yud Kei is mentioned seven times in this parak. Seven, of course, in mystical thought, is completion. That's why, because the world was created in 7 days. That's why a week is seven. That's why Shabbat comes at the end of seven. That's why Shemitah is seven. That's why between Pesach and Shavuot, it's seven times seven. So this creates a mystical completion because of the number of reasons, of times, that we say Ka in chapter 118. Okay. Let's look at 118. Let's look first at the poetry. This comes in couplets. But the couplets are a little odd, as they were in 115. Odu l'Hashem ki tov ki li'olam chasto is the couplet, which is the first pasuk, is the couplet for the last pasuk in this chapter. It is bracketed by give thanks to Hashem for he is good and his mercy continues forever. That's the two bookends to this chapter. Now, look what happens next. Yomarna Yisrael ki lilam chasto, Yomruna Beit Aron ki lilam chasto, Yomruna Yirei Hashem ki lilam chasto. Those three go together. So it's a sort of triplet instead of couplet, because the next one stands on its own. Min hametzar karatika nani b'merchavka. From the depths I called upon Hashem, he answered me with great broadness. The depths and the broadness are, I am depths, I am small, I am nothing compared to what Hashem and the universe are. But Hashem takes note of me and answers me b'merchavka, with the broadness of everything that Hashem is. That pasuk stands on its own, because there is no couplet with the broadness of Hashem. Hashem is the Ein Sof. Hashem is infinite. So that stands on its own. Now look what happens. Hashem li lo yira maya seli adam. Hashem li bios roi ba'ani ara b'sono. Those two go together. Hashem is for me. I won't fear. What can a person possibly do to me? Hashem is for me. Hashem is my helper. I will look upon those who hate me. That goes together. Next. Tov lach sof Hashem mitoach b'adam. Tov lach sof Hashem mitoach b'nidin. It's better to depend on God than to depend on a human being. It is better to depend on God than to depend on princes. Remember last week we were talking about how you can't depend on the idols, atzaveim kesa v'zahav, right? This takes it one step further. You think you can't depend on idols? You can't really depend on human beings either. And if you depend on the princes, the leaders of the government, forget about it. Dependence on Hashem. Kol Adam Kozeh. Everybody is suspect. We can do wrong. Probably not purposefully, but human beings are fallible. Tov lachsos Hashem. It is better to trust in Hashem. Hashem is infallible. Hashem will guide us the right way, whereas a human being may or may not guide us the right way. So that it's one step above not believing in idols. You don't believe in idols? Good. Don't believe completely in the human being either. Believe completely in Hashem. That's the only one to believe in. Why? Kol gayim sabavuni b'shem Hashem ki amilam. Sabuni gam sabavuni b'shem Hashem ki amilam. Again, a couplet. The nations surround me. In the name of Hashem, I will cut them off. They surround me. They really surround me. But in the name of Hashem, I will cut them off. Now, the next pasuk goes with the ones before and the ones after. Sabuni kidvarim. They surrounded me like bees. Do'achu ki'esh kotzim. But they're put out like a fire of thorns. Shem Hashem ki amilam. In the name of God, I cut them off. So that goes with the one before. And it goes with the one after. The chodechi. You thrust at me that I might fall, but Hashem has helped me. Once again, we have that slil hachozer, that sound that repeats. Doachu dacho dechitani. And at the end of this pasuk, in the beginning of the next pasuk, Hashem azarani azi. So even though it's not the same shoresh, which is why it's not a milah chozeret, a repeating word, it's this tzlil hachozer. It's this sound that I keep hearing. And then we get to the dalet, aziv zimraka vayihili bishua, korina bishua, bishua is repeated, v'yohalei tzadikim yamin Hashem osochoyo. Now, that will lead into the next parallel pasuk. Yamin Hashem Romema, Yamin Hashem Al Sachayo. So, this is a couplet both with the pasuk before it and the pasuk after it, and with pasuk chafal, because Yodalit, a Ziv Zimraka by Hili Yeshua, Pasuk Chavalet, Aleph, Odecha Kianikani, Vati Hili Yeshua. So you have the echo in verse 21 echoing back to verse 19. You see what I mean by the tapestry? And unless you immerse yourself in it, you just miss an awful lot of this stuff. Now I come back to the theme of death. Lo amut ki achia v'asaper maseka yasor yisroni ka v'la mavet lo nitanani. I will not die, but I will live and declare the works of Hashem. Hashem has caused me to suffer, but he hasn't allowed me to die. Once I die, I can't sing your praises, Hashem. Only when I am still on this earth. You send me suffering, I'll accept the suffering. But please keep me alive so I can continue to have this ongoing relationship with you as I do now. Next couplet. Pitchu li shari tzedek, ovobamo deka, zehashar lashem tzedik miyobovo. So it's shari tzedek, the gates of righteousness, zehashar. This is the gate of Hashem, and the righteous will enter into it. And then, of course, we get into the psukim that we now double, because now the doubling has stopped, as we talked about a couple of times ago, where Rashi picks up on this in Gemara Sukkah when it talks about this, and we repeat, Odecha Hashem ki amitani vatihi li yishua, even masu habonim, me'et Hashem ha'isazot, hi niflot v'yeinenu, and these are couplets too. From Hashem was this thing, it is wondrous in our eyes. This is the day that Hashem has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. It's sort of like the way we say, Modim in the Amidah, we need to recognize the niflaot around us, the wonders around us. And then, Zehayom asah Hashem nagila v'nismachavo. Is this an imperative? Or is this the outcome from realizing that me'et Hashem haitazot? Realizing that the world is full of wonders that are from Hashem, my reaction will be, Zehayom asah Hashem nagila v'nismachavo. How could I be anything but happy in it? And then we have a divergent pasuk. Ana Hashem oshiyana, ana Hashem hatzlichana. Right in the middle of all this praise, I'm putting just one little bakasha, right? While I'm praising you, Hashem, please save us. Please make us prosper. And the na, if you remember from last week, is now. It's not please. As in, aye na elokeinu, velokeinu bashamayim. Where now is there God? Ana Hashem hoshiyana. I am in such a good place, Hashem. I have just spent 3.5, 4.5 prakim praising you. So now let's take a moment. Please save me. Please make me successful. And then I go right back to the praising again. It's almost a paradigm for the Amidah. Shevach, bakasha, and hodaya. Praise, request, and thanksgiving. And that's what I'm doing here. Hashem is okay with that, right? Because it's this mutual relationship that I have with Hashem, that Hashem has with me. And then, of course, we end with Hodu Hashem Ki Tov Ki Le'olam Chesed. So let's go back to look at some of the parallels. If you go back in chapter 118 to verse 14, the beginning of this verse, Oziv Zimrat Ka, may sound familiar because it is taken whole cloth out of Shirat Hayam. God has saved the Jewish people. They were at the sea. The Egyptians are chasing them. God has them cross the sea on dry land, and the Egyptians drown, and they sing Shirat Hayam. They sing the song of the sea. Oziv Zimrat Ka, Vayehi Li Li Shalom. That's what we're saying here, right? We took it whole cloth out of the what some people believe to be the original Hallel, which is Shirat Hayam. Zeke Livia Veo Keavi Romamen. I am going to extol Hashem. But there's another place that Aziv Zimrat Kavai Hili Yeshua exists, and that's in Sefer Yeshayahu. Although the Nevi'im Achronim, the latter prophets, most of their books are, well, much of their books are about warning the Jewish people that if you don't change your way, you're going to get destroyed. There's a tremendous amount of nechama in them. And this is something, a pasuk that we are so familiar with because we say it every Motzei Shabbat. Hine kel yeshuati eftach v'lo eftach. Behold, God is my salvation. I am going to live in certainty and I'm not going to be afraid. Why? Ki aziv zimrat kav ayihi li lishua. Because Hashem is my strength and my song, and Hashem is my salvation. Because this is taken from Shirat Hayam, this now harkens back to right the beginning of Hallel, B'tzeit Yisrael Mitzrayim, Hayam Ra'a Vayanos. Remember how the sea saw it and it fled? And now we're harkening back to the beginning of Hallel, at the end of Hallel, by repeating the words that Moshe and B'nai Yisrael said the first time that as a nation, Hashem had saved them. Previous to that, they were tribes, they were a clan. Now they're a nation, Hashem has saved them, and I'm going to keep invoking the same pasuk every Motzei Shabbos, every time I say Hallel, Aziv Zimrat Kav Vayehi Li Lishua. Again, we go back to Shirat Hayam in verse 16. Yemincha Hashem Nedari Bakoach. Your right hand, Hashem, is glorious in power. Yemincha Hashem Teratzo Geith, your right hand Hashem shatters the enemy. So when we say Yemin Hashem Romema, what is it Romema for? What is it lifted up for? Teratzo Geith, to shatter the enemy. This again enriches us because it tells us the why of Yemin Hashem Romema. And now, once again, we get back to death. Lo amut ki achya va'asaper ma'aseka. The pasuk in Tehillim, Perek Lamed, is going to tell us why. Ma'vetza bedami biriditi el shachat, hayotcha afar hayageid amitecha. What is to be gained by my death when I go down into the grave? Am I going to be able to attest to your faithfulness then? It's not that people in Olam Haba don't have a relationship with the Kadosh Baruch Hu, by definition they do. What people in Olam Haba have no opportunity anymore to do is to affect this world, to make this world a better place, to proclaim the faithfulness of the Kadosh Baruch Hu. Only while we're alive do we have that opportunity. And so, lo amut ki achyav asaper maseka. I will not die, I will live, because I am bidden to proclaim your faithfulness to those who don't yet recognize it. And this reflects, again, going back to the parak of Hashem Zecharonu Yivarech, lo hametim yahalu luka, lo kol yardei tuma. Those who die cannot praise, but neither can those who go down into the grave. I am so thrilled to have the opportunity to praise Hashem. I want to stay on this earth so that I can praise Hashem. And then I go back to what I said originally. Hallel should be sung out loud because it is a testimony of my praise to Hashem. It is like the Edut of Shema, where I say it loud enough for me to hear it because it's not internal to me. It is my testimony that I believe Hashem is our God and Hashem is one. That's how Hallel is praised. And someone who was at the first shir, we're walking out on Shabbos, and she says to me, I bet you weren't crazy about that Hallel because they didn't sing the whole thing out loud. But it was better than most because the Baal Shacharit was fabulous and had all these wonderful tunes for Hallel. So, Baruch Hashem. Verse 19. Pithu li sharet tzedek ovavam odeka. The parallel comes from Mizmor L'toda, which is Psalm 100. If you go back to Pasuk Aleph in 117, Hallelu Shachu Hodu, Mizmor L'toda Hariu Lashem Kol Ha'aretz. It's interesting because Mizmor L'toda is said in a regular day Shacharit, but not in a Shabbat or Yom Tov Shacharit. So Mizmor L'toda is almost the sort of mini Hallel that we say on regular days, and it is the third aspect. So the beginning of 117 parallels one Pasuk Aleph, the first verse in Mizmor L'toda, and now we come to Pasuk Yotet, which parallels the fourth Pasuk in Mizmor L'toda. Bo Sha'arav, come into his gates, B'todah, with thanks, Chatzerotav, B'tehillah, into his courtyards with Tehillah, with singing, Dulo Baruch Shemo. Thank him and bless his name. So even in the Hallel, we're invoking this Mizmor L'todah that the Davka we don't sing on most of the days we say Hallel, which are the Chagim. We're not talking about Rosh Chodesh and Chanukah, which are Chol, but the regular holidays. Finally, there is an echo of Geula at the end of Hallel. Hallel is not just praising Hashem. As we finish the Hallel, we think about Biyat HaMashiach and Binyan HaMikdash, of the coming of the Mashiach and of the rebuilding of the Mikdash. Odu L'Hashem Ki Tov, Ki Le'olam Chasdo. In this section from Yirmiyahu, Ki Tov Hashem Ki Le'olam Chasdo. Now, you may recognize some of the phrases. Yirmiyah, more than anybody else, is the prophet of destruction. And what we don't realize is some of our happiest, the psukim from our happiest moments also come from Sefer Yirmiyah. Ko amar Hashem, od yishama b'mokom hazeh asher atem omrim charefu. Thus says Hashem, once again will be heard in this place that you say is destroyed, me'ein adam me'ein behema, with no human beings and with no animals, ba'arei Yehuda v'chutzot Yerushalayim, in the cities of Judah and the streets of Yerushalayim, Hanshamot me'ein adam me'ein yoshev me'ein behema, that currently remain without human being and without inhabitant, without animal. Kol sason v'kol simcha, kol chatan v'kol kala. The voice of happiness, the voice of joy, the voice of the groom, the voice of the bride. Kol amrim hodu et Hashem tzvakot ki tov ki le'olam chasdo. The voice of those saying, God of hosts is good, for his mercies endure forever. Mevi'im toda beit Hashem, who bring thankfulness to the house of Hashem, ki ashiv et shvut ha'aretz gevar rishona, amar Hashem. I will return the inhabitants to the land just like they were before, says Hashem. Our pasuk is reflected in one of the psukim of Geula. We're not there now, we understand it. But echoed in Hodu Lashem Ki Tov Ki Le'olam Chasdo is the fact that we will return to Yerushalayim HaKadoshah, that the third Beit HaMikdash will be rebuilt, and we will all once again be together. Even more than this pasuk is the pasuk from Ezra, when the people actually did go back. Ezra is the book of Shivat Zion. After the Babylonian exile, sometime around 70 years, give or take, some of the people came back from Babel with Ezra and started rebuilding the Holy Land again. And look what happens in chapter 3 of Ezra. Vaya'anu b'halel, They answered with Hallel, uvahudot Lashem ki tov ki liolam chasdo, and with thanking Hashem because He is good, because His mercy endures forever. Al Yisrael, on Israel. V'chol ha'am heriu t'ra v'dola be'Hallel Hashem al usad beit Hashem. And all the people lifted a resounding trua in Hallel to Hashem because the foundation of the second Beit HaMikdash had been laid. This says that it can happen again. Udu Hashem ki tov ki liolam chasdo is not only our praising Hashem now where we are, but our thinking that our salvation will come. It's happened before, it will happen again. And as we say Hallel, we're saying Hallel for both what Hashem has done for us in the past and a Hallel in advance for what Hashem will do for us in the future. Ben Hero Vionea. Questions? Comments? Thank you so much for coming. Happy Hanukkah. Oh, and one more thing for those of you who really like this. Remember Rabbi Silver yesterday was talking about how the world began being created on Chaf Hei Elul, and so Hanukkah, Chaf Hei Tishrei, Chaf Hei Kislev. Take a look at the beginning of the Tanakh and count the 25th word and see what you come to. Reshit bara, I can't count. I know the beginning, but I can't count. Reshit bara Elokim et hashamayim ve et haaretz. La'aretz hayta tohu vavohu v'choshech al pnei tahom v'ruach Elokim rachevet al pnei hamayim. Vayomer Hashem yihi or, vayihi or. Or is the 25th word of our Tanakh. How do you like that? Happy Chanukah.